I would like to ask you about this issue. You have been bringing up having more children and progression of families. So there was this competitiveness question that came up, which was between university students, but it definitely goes beyond that. And it is one of the obstacles that young couples face because they feel that it's going to put a break in their career progression. So what is your message towards such young couples who may be facing this dilemma if they would like to have more children, but they feel that it's going to bring a pause?
Well, I think I have a kind of a split message. On the one hand, I fully understand young people wanting to pursue their careers. Whether they're men or women, they want their careers, they've worked hard, they want to become good lawyers, good accountants, good managers, good leaders, or entrepreneurs. So we would like you to do that and yet have kids. We would like you to be a super mom, but not everybody can be a super mom. And so we try to make it easier. Easier in terms of childcare, easier in terms of preschool, easier in terms of affording it because you got the baby bonus, easier in terms of employers having the right attitudes, encouraging their family, their employees to have kids, to be able to bring their children to work, you know, family days, and generally welcoming the family into the workplace and into the whole life of the employee. I think that's one part of it. But the other part of it, which is not perhaps such a welcome message for Singaporeans, is to say, well, we all want everything in life, but we must have a balance in life. And you need to have a balance between wanting to have a family and wanting to have a career. And you have to spend some time on your kids, you have to spend some time bringing them up, looking after them, nurturing them. And it means that time taken is taken off your career. And at the end of the day, when you are, I don't know what is a good end of the day, let's say 70 years old, would you like to look back and say, I've been a super lawyer, or I've had a good career, and I've also had a good family, and I have children, I have grandchildren, and I'm content. I have lived my life well. And I think that it's very difficult to ask a 20-year-old to imagine what a 70-year-old would like to feel, but I think that if you take that perspective, in other words, if you use my framework, 10, 25, and 50 years, on a 10-year perspective, you would pursue your career. On a 25-year perspective, you might have one or two kids. On a 50-year perspective, you might decide the kids come first. And I think that is something which we have not come to terms with. If you look at the Scandinavians who have a lot of kids, they are often content to have three-quarters of a career. They work hard, but they don't work 12 hours or 18 hours a day. They work, they finish in the evening, 3, 4 o'clock. They fetch their kids from childcare, they go home, they spend time with kids. And it's a balance. It's a different kind of society. We are not like that. But it's a balance, and these are choices which we have to make for ourselves.
But the Scandinavian countries, PM, have achieved a higher TFR. They also have huge government support and industrial support for long parental leave, up to a year or so. Do you think Singapore
Scandinavians throw the kitchen sink at the problem. It's not just huge parental support, 6 years or 6 months or 1 year or longer, but they give you everything. I mean, there are the bonuses, there are the childcare. Essentially, every kid has a childcare place, right. And basically half the moms are employed taking care of the kids of other people's other mums, because a big part of the women are employed working as childcare.
But their TFR has gone up.
Their TFR is not bad, 1.6, 1.7.
Do you think Singapore would ever contemplate anything close to that?
Well, if you're prepared to have a GST of 20%, I can imagine funding that. It's up to you.